these 5 years old. But I am five. I'm more than five.
Oh. Well, that's the way it goes.
You're a good man, Charlie Brown.
The only thing wrong with my big brother Charlie Brown is his lack of confidence. His inferiority and his lack of confidence. His clumsiness, his inferiority, and his lack of confidence. His stupidity, his clumsiness, his inferiority, and his lack of confidence.
You're a good man, Charlie Brown. You're the kind of reminder we need.
Did you know that Charlie Brown has never pitched a winning baseball game? Never been able to keep a kite in the air? Never won a game of checkers? And never successfully punted a football? Sometimes, I marvel at this consistency.
You are humility, nobility, and a sense of honor that is good everywhere indeed.
Well, I think Charlie Brown has nice hands.
It truly is a dog's life, filled with many challenges. You try acting excited when that brown-headed kid comes home from school.
You're a prince, and a prince could be king.
All right, now, Linus, I want you to take a good look at Charlie Brown's face. Charlie Brown, could you please hold still a moment? I want Linus to study your face. All right, now, this is what you call a failure. Notice how it has failure written all over it. Study carefully. Notice the deep lines, the dull, vacant look in the eyes. Oh, yes. I'd say this is one of the finest examples of a failure face that your life has seen for a long
while.
Thank you. nothing. Or if anyone would really miss me if I never got out of bed. Then there's the nights, lying there, thinking about all the stupid things I've done during the day. And all the hours in between, when I do all those stupid things. Well, lunchtime is among the worst times of the day. There's a little redhead girl in the lunch over there. Wonder what she would do if I asked her to sit next to me. She'd probably laugh right in my face. It's hard on the face when she's laughing. There's an empty spot next to her on the bench. There's no reason in the world why I couldn't just go over there and sit down. I could do that right now. All I have to do is stand up. I'm sitting down. I'm a coward. I'm so much of a coward she wouldn't even think of looking at me. In fact, she hardly ever does look at me. Why shouldn't she look at me? Is there any reason in the world why she shouldn't look at me? Is she so great and I'm so small that she can't spare one little moment? She's looking at me. She's looking at me.
No, Sally, you're thinking of that other dress. The one I wore to Lucinda's party. The one I'm talking about was very light blue and had a design embroidered around the waist. I don't remember. Well, It was something like this. And the skirt came out like this. And it had puppy show. No, it had a sash. And, it doesn't matter. Anyway, I was talking to Frida. And she told me that...
Lunchtime is among the worst times of the day for me. If that little redhead girl is looking at me with a stupid bag on her head, I must look like the biggest fool alive. Of course, if she isn't looking, maybe I can keep it off and she'd never feel the difference. Then again, I won't know if she was looking unless I take it off. But if I take it off and she isn't looking, I'll be crushed. On the other hand, it's very hard to breathe in here. Not looking at me. I wonder why she never looks at me. But it's one lunch hour we're with. Only 2,863 to go.
Thank you.
that man's personal search for happiness isn't really a selfish thing either, because by finding happiness himself, he can help others to find it. Does that make sense to you?
We have spaghetti at our house 3 times this week.
Space computer, home from school.
Earth?
Hi there, fella. Gosh, it's that little redhead girl and introduce myself. I think I'll introduce myself, and then I'll ask her to sit next to me. I think I'll ask her to sit next to me, and then I'll tell her how much I've always admired her. I think I'll flap my arms and fly to the moon.
Thank you.
single way you could ever become me.
I'm sorry, Lucy, but it's true.
And in the summertime, I'm going to go to my summer palace.
It isn't on the ground. It isn't in a tree.
Are you mad at everybody in the whole world?
I'm mad at everybody!
How about all the animals? And the birds and the fishes? How about the trees and the flowers?
I'm mad at them too! I'm mad at everything!
Are you mad at the sky? How about all the stars? Are you mad at the ground and all the rocks? Are you mad at cars and buildings and circuses and bracelets and roller skates?
Didn't mention jump ropes.
Are you mad at jump ropes?
I'm especially mad at stupid jump ropes!
Here, Izzy, this is for you. Happy Valentine's Day.
Is that right?
Happy Valentine's Day, Lucy. This is for you. You can do it, you just don't get nervous. Here, Lucy, happy Valentine's Day. Here, Lucy, Merry Christmas! Oh. I would give anything if that little redhead girl sent me a Valentine. Maybe she did send me one. Maybe it's a poem in my mailbox right now.
Not very much of a person.
That's certainly
true. There is reason.
mother was the daughter of the chief overseer of the kitchen.
Whatever! Shrugger, I just want you to know that I'm on your side. I'm going to help you publicity wise to pay Chuck's birthday. It is such a big deal.
Listen, that's great, Lucy, but I just don't want to see Beethoven Day commercial.
Commercial?
Yeah, next thing you know, I'll be wearing Beethoven's sweat.
Beethoven Day?
Beethoven Day, I'm gonna jump up, I'm gonna dance, 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 I
change on us.
Thank you.
for something is about.
Thank you.
What?
That's my new philosophy. Oh yeah? That's what you think.
Well, why are you telling me?
What?
Why are you telling me?
Why are you telling me? I like it. That's a good philosophy. Why are you telling me? When we get to the playing field, you can say,
one chance?
Yeah.
All right. What do you say, team? Give me a T.
T.
Give me an E.
E.
Give me an A.
A.
Give me an M.
M.
What does it spell?
T. There is no T like the best T, which is our T right here. Who was she anyway? Did she ever get to be queen?
Not quite sure how to answer that, Lucy.
You're bound to need that, Cassandra. All answers will be held in the strictest confidence.
Still, Lucy, that's a very hard question to answer.
Well, you can have a couple moments to think it over, or we can come back to that question later.
I think I'd like to come back to it, if you don't mind.
Oh, not at all. This next question deals with certain character traits you might have observed. Regarding my personality, would you say that I'm A, fearful, B, pleasing, or C, objectionable? Would that be A, B, or C? What's wrong, Sheldon Brown? What's your answer to that big question? No,
I guess I'm very objectionable. Forceful. I guess I have to say forceful, Lucy, but,
Okay. Well, I guess I'll check A then. This next question is about my people skills. Yes, now, regarding my ability to get along, of course, would you say that's poor, fair, good, or excellent?
Well, you see, I think that depends a lot on what you mean by get along with other people.
You know, big friends, sparkle in a crowd, that sort of
thing. You have space for extension?
Sure, I'll just put a check mark at none of the above. Okay, this question deals with physical appearance. In referring to my beauty, would you say that I was A, stunning, B, mysterious, or C, intoxicating?
Gee, Lucy, I don't know. You look just fine to me.
Stunning. All right, well. You best be getting back to that first question. On a scale of 0 to 100, you can give me a standard 50. Is that something you might want
to do? I remember the question, Lucy.
Well.
51?
51 is your crabbiness rating for me. All right. That about does it, I guess. Thank you very much for your cooperation, Charlie Brown.
Anytime. Come on, Scoopy.
All right. Oh, one more. Would you answer yes or no to the following question? Is a Lucy Venhaus the sort of person you'd like to have as the president of your club or civic organization?
Oh, yes. By all means, Lucy. Yes.
Well, who are you? Yes! Yeah! All right. 51. None of the above. I'm sure I was right. I can already feel myself being filled with the glow of self-awareness. Oh, Sally, I'm conducting a survey and I wonder if 110. C, 4, none of the above, no. And what are you going to do about the dent that you left in my bicycle? It's amazing how fast one of these surveys gets around.
Sure, Lucy.
All right. Well, on a scale from 0 to 100, using a standard 50 is average, 75 is above average, and 90 is exceptional, where would you rank me with regards to crabbiness?
You are my sister.
Oh, that's not the question.
No, but that's the answer.
Answer the question, Linus.
Look, you and I both know that if I answer that question with any sort of honesty, you are going to slug me.
Oh, Linus. A survey that's not based on honest answers is like a house built on the foundation of sand. Now, when I was spending my time to conduct the survey, if I didn't expect complete candor in all the responses, now, I promise I won't slug you from the bottom. So, what was your credit rating for me?
95.
surprise me, but I think Lucy knows now that she can't be crappy.
Anymore.
Where is everybody? I told them to be here.
You told them to be here.
We don't rehearse, we can't sing in the assembly tomorrow.
The assembly tomorrow?
Charlie Brown.
Charlie Brown.
Linus.
Linus.
Lucy.
Give me back my pencil, you blockhead.
No, that's what you give me back my grand.
If you don't give me back my pencil, I'll tell Sally when you said that.
Stop that.
What did you say about me?
He said stop that! You're late. We've got to rehearse.
I'm sorry, I'm late. Let's do
there's no time to be sorry!
What did he say?
He said
wait! Remember, this is a mood piece. We must paint a picture with music and words. So concentrate!
Give me my pencil.
No.
grief.
Thank you.
that's a start. But it could be a plan. Or maybe even a satellite.
It could be a satellite. I wonder.
Well, we'll never find out just by standing here.
Where are you going?
I'm going to take a closer look.
Goodness.